Can Excel have a searchable data validation list? This is one of the common questions I get on this channel.
So here I have a data validation list. When I click on it, I get the list of all customers. To find one, I have to scroll and find the name. Now here comes the part of it being searchable. If I type in GAR and I click on this, I get the list of names that only include GAR. Now notice that it doesn't have to be at the beginning of the name, it can be anywhere in the name. If I type in Rob and I click on the down arrow, I get the list of names that include the word Rob. And if I remove that, click on this, I go back to the full list.
Now if you look for this online, you're going to find a few VBA solutions. I also cover a VBA version which uses user forms inside my VBA course. But how about doing this without VBA? Until now, you needed complex formulas and complex data preparation to set it up. You pretty much had to be a very advanced Excel user. Not anymore. Let me show you how you can easily set it up with dynamic arrays. But please note that dynamic arrays are available in Office 365 for now in the Insider Edition, but soon for everyone using Office 365. Let's get to it.
So this is where I want to have my searchable dropdown list. Once the user searches for a customer, they select a customer name, they automatically get the company the customer works for. The list of my master data is inside the master data tab. We can see customer and company here. This list is not an official Excel table yet, but I'm going to turn it into an official Excel table towards the end so that every time we add in new customers, our searchable data validation list is going to include that customer name as well without us having to do anything. Ultimately, what I want to do is to have my list here, but somehow I need to create a separate list somewhere that restricts the names to the names that include the words I type in here. So when I type in GAR, I need somewhere a list generated of names that only include GAR. Now currently, dynamic arrays works well with names, right? So names in name manager, but data validation lists don't work with names that have dynamic array formulas in them, right? So I have to create a data preparation table for that, and I'm going to do it right here. Okay, so anytime the user types in JR in here, I want my data preparation table to give me a list of customers that include the word JR. One formula that helps us identify which names have, let's say, JR included in them is the search formula. So let me just demonstrate this. So instead of switching back and forth from the report tab to master data tab, I'm just going to act like my input field is right here. So I'm going to be typing in GAR, and right here I want to see a list of customers that include GAR. But let's see how the search function can help us with that. Search needs these arguments. First argument is what text we're looking for, so that's what we're going to be typing in. Where are we looking it up? We're going to be looking it up here. Actually, it's going to be the full list, but let me just show you what search actually returns. The last argument is optional, is where do we want it to start looking, like which position? Well, in this case, we always want it to start to look for that name from the beginning, right? From position one, so I can leave that empty. So what do I get here? I get a number back, and the number is the position of this name in here. So if I switch this to M, what do you think I'm going to get? 6, because M is the 6th position in this name. And if I switch this to a letter that's not in the name, I get an error. Right? So basically, I get either a number, if it's in there, or an error if it's not in there. Now let me just apply this to the full range here. And this is where we can see the advantage of the new dynamic array aware Excel. So instead of looking for this in A2, I'm going to look for it in the entire range. So Control Shift down, and then I'm going to press Enter, and my formula spills. So it gives me all errors because all of these don't have V in there. This one does, and that's in the 4th position, and the rest don't either. So if I switch this to Rob now, we can see numbers and errors. So what I want to do is to convert these numbers and errors to true and falses. So if it has a number, it should be a true. And if it doesn't have a number, it should be a false. So I can use the isNumber function here. And just wrap this up in there, press enter. Now I get my false and true values in here. So now we can move on to the next function that can filter this list and just give us the trues back. And a great formula for that is a new dynamic array formula called the filter function. We need to define the array that we want filtered. So basically, what do we want to see back here? We want to see a list of customer names. So control shift down to select the whole range. The next argument is what do we want included? And we already have our true and false values here. So filter is just going to include the true values in here. Now the last argument is what do we want it to show if it's empty? So if it doesn't find anything, I'm just going to put not found. Okay, so when we type in Rob, we get the list of names that include the word Rob. If I type in V, I just get one. And if I type in something that's not there, I get not found. Okay, so that works well. It's just that we're not going to be typing here. I'm actually just going to call this data validation prep. But instead, I'm going to change that reference to search in here. So in that cell, I had GAR, and I get my data validation preparation list showing me the names that include GAR. Notice that my customer list here is a list of unique values. If yours isn't unique, so if you have Robert Spear mentioned a few times, you want to get the unique list back. All you have to do is wrap this up inside the unique function. But in my case, I don't need to do it because I have a list of unique values here. Now, also, if I wanted this to be sorted, I can also wrap this up inside the sort function. Okay, so actually, let's do that. Now, as a next step, all I have to do is to get my dropdown in here. So I'm going to go to Data, Data Validation. Under Settings, I'm going to select List. For Source, we're going to go to Master Data. We're going to click on the first cell that has our main formula, and we want the entire spill array, so the entire spill range. I need to put a hashtag in there, and I say OK. So when I click this, I get the list of names that include GAR. Now, there is one setting we need to change, because if I type in something new and I click this, I get an error telling me this value doesn't match the data validation restrictions defined for this cell, right? Because it doesn't find Rob in that list. So I'm going to click on cancel and go back to data validation. Under error alert, I need to take away the check mark. Show error alert after invalid data is entered. And I say okay. So now if I type in Rob and I click on this, there's no alert. My data preparation list updates, so does my data validation list. Now the aim is also to get the company that this person works for. Now here you can use VLOOKUP, you can use index and match, but since filter is one of my favorite formulas right now, I'm gonna use that. So our array is company, right? Because that's what we want to get back. What we want included is the customer that equals the customer that we select right here. And as the last argument, if it's empty, I'm just going to put nothing. Close and enter. Now, if I'm just typing something in like M and I click here, notice that it doesn't return anything, right? Because I said if it doesn't find it, it should show nothing. And then once I click something, then it shows the company. Now, if I look for something that's not on the list, I also get nothing, and when I click on this, it just says Galila's not found. Now let's go to the part where we can add in new customers and get our list to automatically update without us having to do anything, right? So we're going to take advantage of Excel table functionality. So all I have to do is turn this data set into an official Excel table. So just click anywhere inside and press Control T. My table does have headers. Just click on OK. I'm just going to go and clear the design. and call this table customer and press enter. I don't really have to do anything anymore. All I have to do is just go and add in my names. And let's go to my report, type in Leila, and click on this, and I get Leila Gharani. And this formula updates automatically as well because it understands that the source data has changed into an official table, so it expands the formula range as well.
Now, I know it can be frustrating if you don't have dynamic arrays, but if you have Office 365, it's coming. And if you're excited to get dynamic arrays, click that like button. Once they're there, you're going to be one of the first to know how to create searchable dropdown lists without VBA. I'll keep you updated, so if you're not subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing.